Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show us how to make this one love earring. So you can see this earring. So to start with this, I have this two pipe bead. I have two of my pipe bead. I have this earring hook. I have size 2 seed bead. And I have my size 8 rand bead. And I have size 6 crystal bead. And also my quarter. And I have my fishing line. So to start, I'm going to cut my fishing line. I'm using two different fishing lines. This one I'm cutting now. The first one, I'm using size 40. Size 40. Then I'll pick this. So to start with, I'm going to pick the 6 beads here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, like this, and I'm going to tie it. I'm using size 40 fishing line to make it firm so that it will be strong. So this is what I have here. You can tie it 3 times like this. So after tying it like this, you cut it, you cut out the excess. So after cutting it, you have it like this. So this is 6. So at this point, you fix your needle on a different fishing line. We are using 2 needles at this point. And this is 0.30 fishing line. Cut a comfortable fishing line you can handle. Then fix the 2 needles. We're using 2. So at this point, you take this and pass your needle through one of this bead like this and make your fishing line equal. This is it. We're coming out of 1. So at this point, you're going to pick 2 seed bead with your right needle and 2 seed bead with your left needle, and you drop it. After dropping it, you pick 1 crystal bead with your right and 1 on your left. And you drop it like this. As you can see, I have mine like this. Then you take 2 seed beads to crisscross it. Crisscrossing, taking 2 on your right bead, then you, in opposite direction, you pass your left needle, and you have it like this. So at this point, this is what you have. So this is it. So at this point, you hold your left fishing line. At this, we're going to work with 1 fishing line at this point. So the next thing to do here is I'll pick 2 fishing line with my right needle, and I'll pick one crystal and also and another two seed bead like this. Then this is where this we came out from before. Then I would skip this line here and pass through this one, coming back this way. So this is what I have here. Then coming out here, I'll pick two seed bead again. I'll pick two seed bead. After picking two seed bead, I'll pick one crystal bead like this. Then remember these two we picked before, this is the two. Then I'll pass through the two again like this and drag my needle out. So at this point, you should be having it like this. This is it. You have to make it firm. It will come out. Just don't bother. As you're doing it, it will be firm. When you tie it together, it will be tighter. So here we are. Like this is what we have. So at this point, remember you will still hold your left fishing line. Then pick another two. I pick two seed bead, one crystal bead, and another two seed bead like this. Another two seed bead. So after picking it, I pass it. Remember, after picking it, I'll pass it through this one here. I skip this space here. This space, if you can see, I pass it through this one here. This is what I have. After passing it like this, I pick two seed beads and a crystal bead. And this is the two I picked first. I'll pass through these two like this. So after passing through the needle like this, then I'll hold it and drag it. So at this point, you're going to bring them together. Are you seeing it? This is what I have here. So having it like this, then you tie the two needles. I'm going to tie it at this point. This is how tight. So I'll tie it three times. I'm taking my time to do this so that you understand and see very well. So this is it. At this point, I have it like this. So this is it. So now we have this. Because it's earring we're making, we're going to cover this side as well. Like this, like the way we did this side. We'll do the same thing here. So at this point, you take your right fishing line, pass through these two seed beads close to where you tied it, and find your way down to this, and do the same thing with your left. Since your left one is here, then you're passing straight directly through the crystal bead. You're passing through the crystal bead here and the two seed bead down. So this is what you should have now. your needle facing this way. Then you crisscross here, passing your needle in opposite direction. So crisscrossing here, you pass your left needle to this big one, and you also take your right needle, pass it through like this. Both should be coming out like this. So at this point, we have our fishing line facing this way, and we've turned to the back. So we'll do the same thing we did by picking 2 seed beads on our right fishing line and 2 on the left fishing line. Pick a crystal on the right, a crystal on the left, and pick 2 seed beads. After picking the 2 seed beads with your right fishing line, then you crisscross it like this. You see what we have? So you see it will be coming out like this, this way. So at this point, we're going to do the same thing we did, holding this rope with your left hand while using your right to go around. So as you're holding it like this, you're going to pick 2 seed bead. You pick 2 seed bead, pick 1 crystal, another 2 seed bead, like this. So remember this line here, we're leaving it, we're going through this one, coming back like this. I have it like this, remember? So this is what I have here. So at this point, I'm going to pick 2 seed bead. 2 seed bead with 1 crystal bead. Then I'm going to pass through these 2 here. These 2 bead that I picked initially, like this. Then I'll drag my rope. So at this point, I should be having something like this. Don't be scared of what you're getting at this point. When you tie it, it will come together. So we have these 2 here, like this. So we should do the same thing with the other one. Still remember, you're holding this. So at this point, I'm going to pick 2 seed bead, 2, 1 crystal, and another 2 seed bead. So now, as we have only 2 space here, then I will leave this first one, then I will go through this back. I'll go through the back of this. So you see what I have. So at this point, I'll pick 2 seed bead again, 2 seed bead, 1 crystal. So remember, I'm coming out here. I'm going to pass it through these 2 seed bead here, the 2 I picked initially, like this. So I have it together. So after doing this, you have it together like this again. Then at this point, I'm going to tie it together. I'm tie 3 times. I'll tie 3 times to bring the 3 of it together. So after tying it like this, then I'm going to take my fishing line and pass it through my left fishing line, my right fishing line, sorry, I'll pass it through these two, coming out through this crystal bead here. Coming out through this crystal bead, I pass it through this two here. Then I'll take my left, I'll pass directly through this crystal and the two seed beads like this. So the two should be facing this way. Then at this point, I'm crisscrossing it through the big one here. That's a size 8 rand bead. So at this point, you see what I have. My rope is facing up the two. So look at what I have here. I have this, and look at the back. I have the same thing. These two. You see, because it's earring, it will dangle. So when people look at it, they will see both front and back. You see it? They are all the same. You can't tell the front and the back of this earring. So now it's time to put a straw bead. So coming at in this direction, you pick one straw bead on your right needle and one straw bead on your left needle. So having these two straw bead like this, I'll pick one seed bead and pass my two needle through it, just like this. Take one and pass these two needle through this. So at this point where you have your two needle pass through the bead, you have it now like this. Then you pick two seed bead with your right needle and pick two seed bead with your left needle. And you have it done like this. So here you have the hook you're going to use. So at this point, you do a crisscross with it, passing your right needle and your left needle through this earring hook by crisscrossing it like this. So when you do this, you have this. Hope you can see it. So when you crisscross, so after crisscrossing, at this point I'm going to reinforce this straw bead and the seed bead here, finding my way down. Now you have it like this, this way. So I'm going to pass my needle through these two seed bead here and the first one we picked here like this, and I'll find my way down the pipe bead. Here we go. So I'll do the same thing with my left needle. Since I'm coming out like this, then I'll pass through this two, through these two seed bead here, then pass through this one down. So after having it like this, coming out of this, then you pass your left needle down here like this. So doing it like this will make this place firmer and harder. So having it like this, at this point, then you pass your left needle through this one here. You come out here and take your right needle. Do the same thing with your right needle like this. So at this point, after coming out here, then you pass your right needle through these beads, all these beads here. Come out here and take this one. Both of them should meet at a point like this. So meeting here, you tie, make a loop here, just make sure you tie it firmly here, 3 times.
This is the finished design. This is the finished design. Go ahead and do yours. If you have any question on this, don't hesitate to ask. And if you find this video interesting, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, comment, share my videos and like them. See you next time. Bye.